Good morning, children. Welcome back to our English class. So we are on the 30th day of June 2020. Today, again, we are going to see grammar. And we were learning the topic nouns. So, in the kinds of nouns, we have completed common noun, proper noun, collective noun. And today we are going to see possessive noun. Children, in today's class, I'm going to just give you few exercises. Okay? Not Google form. But here is a condition. You must learn thoroughly all these kinds of nouns, all these four kinds of nouns along with basic nouns, so that in my next class I'll be forwarding you a Google form and you will have all these kinds of nouns which you need to answer. So children, take your time. After completing today's exercise, please go through all the previous videos and learn all these four kinds of nouns. You can use your grammar book if you have it. Otherwise, you can go through all the videos, the Google Forms and the PDF formats that I have sent you. Now, read the following sentences. Ria is wearing a new dress. Ria's dress is very pretty. In sentence 1, Ria's dress means the dress belonging to Ria. Can you see, dear children? Near the noun Ria, there is an apostrophe plus yes, which shows the belonging of the particular person. Now see the second sentence. The bird's nest is very cozy. C-O-Z-Y. Cozy means comfortable. In sentence 2, bird's nest means the nest belonging to a bird. Again, can you spot an apostrophe plus yes? So children, the words with apostrophe plus the letter S are possessive nouns. So what is the definition of a possessive noun? A possessive noun shows who or what something belongs to. An apostrophe is used to show belonging. Now let us see a few more examples. Mohit's book. So here it means the book belonging to Mohit. Girl's pencil. The pencil of the girl. Aman's songs. Here it means the songs sung by Aman. Children's books. Here it means the books meant for children. Children, do not confuse plural versus possessive. Plural shows more than one. Three parties, two gifts, three balloons. Whereas possessive shows ownership. The child's cake. The student's games. Now see, you are using a mobile or a laptop to listen to this video. Is it not, children? Okay. Now, if the mobile which you are having belongs to your mother, then how do you say? You will say, my mother's mobile. If it belongs to your father, you will say, my father's mobile phone. So, when something talks about the belonging, then we must use a possessive form to denote that. Now children, here are a few points to remember. Singular nouns are made possessive by adding an apostrophe plus the letter s. Now see the example. Sara's book is on the table. Here, the book that belongs to Sara is on the table. Now Sara is our singular noun because she is only one person. Now, if you have to make the singular noun as a possessive noun, then you must add apostrophe plus yes. Now have a look at this point. We put apostrophe after plural nouns ending in yes or es. Now see the examples. Birds' wings. Again here the noun for us is not singular. It is plural. Can you see more than one bird in the picture? So now the birds becomes our plural noun, right? So you must add apostrophe after the letter yes. See the other example. Ladies' purses. So there is not only one lady, there are more than one. So the apostrophe is added after the plural word. Now look at this point. We put apostrophe yes after plural nouns which do not end in yes or es. Now see the examples. Can you see lot of men there? So now here the plural form doesn't have yes because it is called as irregular plural. So in this example, men's ties. All of them are wearing a tie. So ties also will become plural, but we are going to say the possession which all these men have. So we say it as men's ties. Same goes with women's saris. Can you spot? There are four women there. So we say women's saris. Now here is your last point. Apostrophe yes is normally not used with non-living things. See the example. The top of the page. You should not say page top. Okay? Also remember this. The boy's bat means there is one boy and one bat. If we say the boys bats, then we have one boy and several bats. When we say the boys bat, there are several boys but one bat. When we say the boys bats, there are several boys and several bats. Now it's your assignment time, children. One example assignment I have given in the slide, whereas the remaining I'll be giving you as a PDF format. Okay? Do you all remember what I told you in the beginning? Complete the exercises which you would get as a PDF format, and answers for these exercises I will be posting it after all your classes. Okay? So what you must do is check the answers again with the help of the answer key which I am going to send you. And children, do not forget to learn all the kinds of nouns. Those who have your grammar book can do these exercises in your grammar book. Find out the topic and do the exercises. Those who don't have your grammar book, use the PDF format and write it in your notebook. Bye bye, children. Have a nice day.